Hello everybody, this is an old copying system, the James Watt letter copy press. It was invented in 1780 by James Watt, the inventor who invented also the steam engine. It has been the first reliable copying machine, and its operating principle was used in copying machines till the beginning of the 1900s. I will give a general presentation and then I will do some copies with it. James Watt patented both a screw press like this and a portable web version like the model I'm presenting in this video. It is said that James Watt invented this machine because he had a lot of correspondence with his partner Matthew Boulton while traveling between London and Cornwall. James Watt was often frustrated when he received Boulton answers to his own written questions after several weeks, as he had no copy of the original correspondence. This model was built by T. Clark, Exeter Exchange, London. The box is made in mahogany with corners and handles in brass. Inside there is a writing plane for preparing the documents. It is covered in felt. There is a crank in brass, must be assembled. There is a screw to fix it and inserted here. There is also some compartments which contained the little boxes for the ink and the cleaning tools. The copy is to be placed here. There is also this drawer on the side for accessories and paper. On the side there are two brass rollers with the gears on the sides. And turning the crank, the plate with the copy is advanced through these brass rollers. The pressure will make the copy, we will see later. In the compartment underneath there are two books. This one is the dumping book where I think is placed the paper to be moistened, with many pages of blotting paper. And this one, the drying book where you should place the paper to be dried. Here there are some waterproof paper sheets. You can use these if you want to do many copies at the same time. We will see later. On the first page of these books there is a manual. You can download it in the link in the description if you want to see it. If you agree, I can try to do a copy with this device. It's okay. First of all, I have to write the original. I use a normal sheet of paper and I write on it with special ink. It's a ink glycerin or rubber based. Watt's inventions had a lot of success. Many notable people such as George Washington, Thomas Jefferson and Benjamin Franklin used these devices. After I wrote the letter, I wait till it's dried. Now I will do the copy. I take the letter I wrote and I place on it a very thin paper. Then I place on both a tissue dampened with water. I place all this on the plate of the device. You should take care that the water is completely absorbed and not seen on the paper, as it may cause the ink to spread. But the paper should be sufficiently damped, of course. and I advance the plate through these rollers, turning the crank. Since the ink I used is soluble in water, the device used the pressure to transfer ink from the original document to a damp piece of paper. The water dissolved the ink, and the ink was deposited on the paper in contact with the original copy. You could obtain some tens of copies before the ink faded. The result is a mirror image. But using a very thin sheet of paper and placing it on a white sheet of paper, the mirror image copy could be read from the other side of the page. You see? And by placing the waterproof oiled paper we saw before between multiple layers of tissue, paper and copies, you could also make copies of several documents at the same time. This technology remained in use for more than 100 years after James Watt invented it. It also had many clones and different formulas of ink. Then this technology was substituted by flat stencil mimeographs, then drum mimeographs, always more efficient, till alcohol duplicator after the war, and in the end the photocopier. When you see this device, you can see how long has been the road of 250 years from the first model in 1780 to the current digital copiers in 2024. If you want to see a press of beginning of 1900s based on the same principle, you can watch this video. Have a nice day.